My name is Sister Karen Butler.
We also started the Day of the Dead around 1973 or 72 or 3. We just simply walked to a cemetery and had a small service there. And then the following year, one of the largest years that we had was in 1974. And a lot of different artists were involved. I would say probably about 100 different artists. Essentially, we're more or less doing, we're still doing the Day of the Dead. We always have a very large celebration. People would like now for us to do some workshops, again, to get behind the meaning of the Day of the Dead, which is to remember people in your family or people you know that have died.
Hello, relatives. I'm Tina Orduna Calderon, Gabrielino Tongva, Ventureño Chumash, and Yoreme.
Mi hija nehinkam netwanyane Jessica Calderon, and I am Tina's daughter.
So we're here today in Los Angeles, and we'd like to honor our relatives, past and present, the original caretakers of Tawangad, from San Fernando Valley to Huntington Beach, east along the Santa Ana River to Riverside and Corona, and back along the foothills. We also held the four Channel Islands, Santa Barbara, Santa Catalina, San Clemente, and San Nicolas. And we are still here today. We're doing our very best to continue to protect our Earth Mother, our waters, our animal relatives, and our plant relatives.
And we ask that as long as you are here in our lands, or any lands rather, that you acknowledge that you are a steward of the land and honor her in that way as she honors you by providing shelter, food, and water. We would have none of that without our Mother Earth.
So let's remember to walk lightly upon our Earth Mother and to respect her and give her the dignity that she deserves. So with the song,
we're gonna step into an ancestor song to acknowledge the ancestors of this land, the Tongva peoples, as well as honoring the four directions, which includes your ancestors.
Way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah hey yo. Way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah hey yo. Me komi ketai me pai me. Yarar kamo krehnuk vetam tu me komi ketai me pai me. Way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah hey yo. Way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah hey yo. Yarar kamo krehnuk vetam tu me komi ketai me pai me. Way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah hey yo. Way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah, way ah hey ah hey yo. Yarar kamo krehnuk vetam tu me komi ketai me pai me. Yarar kamo krehnuk vetam tu me komi ketai me pai me. way-ah-hey-ah-way-ah-hey-ah-way-ah-hey-ah-hey-o. Way-ah-hey-ah-way-ah-hey-ah-way-ah-hey-ah-hey-o. Yarar como crejenut betam tu me comiquetaime paime. Yarar como crejenut betam tu me comiquetaime paime.
And I'd just like to remind you that this is the time of year where it is okay to acknowledge your loved ones on the other side, to acknowledge your ancestors and tune into them, because now is the time of the year where our worlds are merging and we are more in tune to them than the rest of the days of the year. So acknowledge them, love them, ask for information and guidance that you need, and be blessed.
Thank you so much. Blessings to you all. Te hof kopo ami. May you go well.
Thank you. everybody, and welcome to the 47th annual Día de los Muertos celebration at Self-Help Graphics and Art. My name is Marta Gonzalez.
And I am Annie Gonzalez. And we will be your co-hosts for today's special events. And here with us, we have the Executive Director of Self-Help Graphics and Art. Without further ado, we'd like to welcome Miss Betty Avila.
Thank you, Marta and Annie, for that wonderful introduction. We're so thrilled that you'll be joining us today as we transmit the sights and sounds of Día de los Muertos from our house to your home. Día de los Muertos is a sacred time for self-help graphics and art. And we first want to thank Tina and Jessa Calderon for the beautiful Tongva land acknowledgement. They are original descendants of the stewards of this land who are first displaced. And while we can't gather in person, I really want to thank Danza Divina de Los Angeles for sharing with us the beautiful medicine that Danza Azteca brings to our community.
All right, up next, we welcome solo artist Katzù Oso. Katzù combines a dreamy synth-drenched sound with influences from growing up in East LA.
Self-Help Graphics and the Paramount for putting this lovely event together for Día de los Muertos. Thank you. We're Katzù Oso. Check us out everywhere.
Oh baby, eres para
Thank you, guys.
Thank you to Katzù Oso. That was beautiful. Yay! Part of the magic and the cornerstone of the Dia de los Muertos season at Self Help Graphics is its Dia de los Muertos exhibition and commemorative print.
Yes, and this year, Self Help selected artist Sandy Rodriguez as its commemorative print artist and exhibition curator. The result of this collaboration is Ofrendas 2020, a virtual exhibition on view through November 27th that bridges art and the sacred altar. Take a look.
I'm Sandy Rodriguez. I'm welcoming you to the 47th annual Day of the Dead celebration at Self Help Graphics. I hope that you will enjoy our online exhibition. It includes three generations of artists that are Los Angeles based. We have 17 exhibiting artists for the exhibit, so you're going to have some stunning traditional elements that you may be expecting as part of a Day of the Dead exhibition, and some more radical and experimental interpretations, including video, installation, altars, paintings, ceramics. Rigo Maldonado is doing a big sculptural installation. So the works will be very small and personal, like small nichos. Two very room-sized ofrendas. I've also invited the Young Center to create an altar for child migrants who have passed this year. But you're going to see artworks that are ofrendas for environmental activists that have been killed in the line of their work, to people whom we've lost, obviously, through COVID-19, to ofrendas to grandmothers, tios and tias, cousins. It's going to be really how we do Day of the Dead here in Los Angeles, interpreted again by about three generations of artists that are a big part of the Los Angeles cultural fabric and the Self-Help Graphics family. The Dia de los Muertos commemorative print for the 47th annual Dia de los Muertos celebration at Self-Help Graphics is dedicated to my mamita, Guadalupe Rodriguez, who passed this past summer in 2019. And she would have loved to be in the show with so many of these artists who she showed with so many times for Day of the Dead on so many different occasions across Los Angeles. So, Guadalupe Rodriguez presente. It was in the spring when I was approached by Self Help to create the commemorative print for the Dia de los Muertos 47th annual celebration this year. So we decided on a painting of my mom's, Guadalupe Rodriguez, and her autorretrato in El Panteón from a Dia de los Muertos intercambio trip that we had taken to Mexico. So the image is based on her oil painting, which is her self-portrait in a cemetery in Pátzcuaro. And so it's got all of the little elements that we really kind of learned more about in the traditions of Central Mexican celebrations of Day of the Dead. The commemorative print and objects from the exhibition will be available on our site for purchase. And I encourage you to take your time and browse all of the selections that are available and bring one home today.
Hello, I'm Hilda L. Solis, Los Angeles County Board of Supervisor, representing the 1st District. On Dia de los Muertos, those who have passed always have special meaning in our hearts. But this year, these losses are felt by us as a collective human race. These times are certainly challenging. But I want you to know that the County of Los Angeles is with you, and we thank you for your continuing to do your part to slow the spread of COVID-19. You are all our heroes. Muchas gracias, and si se puede.
Volando ya Endy, saludos, me llamo Endy, estoy en el territorio Tongva. Con el permiso de los antepasados de estas tierras, estoy aquí platicando con ustedes sobre el Día de los Muertos. Es un día para honrar y tomar nuestro tiempo para convivir otra vez con nuestros antepasados o personas que ya han ido al otro mundo. Al crear un altar es fortalecer la conexión con nuestros antepasados. Como comunidad ya llevamos más de 47 años en Self-Help Graphics como artistas y mamás y tías y tíos y abuelos disfrutando en crear las ofrendas para los altares. Estas tradiciones no tienen dueño. No pertenecen a una persona, a un grupo, a una ciudad, etc. Y nosotras y nosotros somos responsables, tenemos el honor y la responsabilidad de cuidar a las tradiciones. En Los Ángeles, como familia, en el territorio Tongva, estamos aquí unidos, Grand Park, Self-Help Graphics, y hay varias otras organizaciones en esta ciudad, en este territorio, que celebran y honran a los antepasados a través de Día de los Muertos. Igual así, en otras ciudades, en otros continentes, celebran los antepasados y todos juntos nos unimos a cultivar ese amor.
The origin of Noche de Ofrenda began at Self-Help Graphics, I believe in the early 90s. I had been doing altars at Self-Help Graphics since the 1982, but as a part of the community altars. But then it evolved into, I was then asked to do altars in the gallery as for my own piece with other artists. And so when I started making a presentation on the altars, it was called Noche de Ofrenda. But it evolved into a very beautiful event where it was just about the ofrendas, and it was very intimate, and with the lights turned low and candles lit, and people that were invited to bring an ofrenda or just sit and contemplate and, you know, spend time together and remembering their loved ones. It was all about the remembrance and the ofrenda. It became a tradition or an annual thing. I think it's a time for healing and for, you know, coming together, although we were not coming together physically, but spiritually. And I think the significance of Día de Muertos is even more important today.
Well, this tradition is, you know, from Self-Help Graphics, has been a community tradition. You know, it's brought the Chicano community together for over 40 years. And now at Grand Park, I think it's almost 10 years now that we've been here. And it's going beyond our community and into the rest of LA. We've talked about the ofrenda being that connection, being the bridge that connects the living and the dead, connects generations. And now it's connecting us in so many other ways and so many levels.
Self-Help Graphics and Grand Park have been collaborating on Día de los Muertos observances since 2013, and we're so honored and humbled that Self-Help Graphics entrusts us with this collaboration. It's also a way in which the park serves its mission as the park for everyone. Here we work year-round to reflect, honor, and celebrate Los Angeles, and being entrusted with this collaboration to uplift the celebration of Día de los Muertos is one of the cornerstones of our year here at Grand Park. Self-Help Graphics is they're the culture bearers of this event. They are the, like I said, the pioneers. They are the storytellers. They are the ritual holders. And we at the park are here to honor that and to uplift it. Grand Park is meant to reflect, honor, and celebrate Los Angeles. That's how we live and breathe as the park for everyone. And so to come together year after year with Self-Help Graphics and be a home for this tradition that they built so many years ago is a beautiful way in which we do what we're here to do at Grand Park for Los Angeles. And we're grateful every year that they bring this amazing tradition and the beautiful artwork and the beautiful community altars here to the park. And we look forward to many, many more years.
Junctures, empalmes, spaces between vértices, relatedness to all there is within the minute, the finite, as this is to that, like one to the other, nepantla, memory of place, unreconciled nostalgia, como cuerda, lumínica, not opposites or similar, pero en conjunto, continuo, o algo así. Texture as narrative, que lleve el sonido del fondo al trozo del mar. Es convivencia. Reciban la ofrenda, the unfolding with delight. An offering of starbursts releases us for ourselves to know it is the spirit which draws us near, the embrace of the infinite that pulls and pulses in each of us, the flame and endless flight. Una ofrenda de nebula nos libera. Al recibirnos, para nosotros saber. El espíritu acercándonos, el abrazo del infinito tira y pulsa en cada quien, la llama, un vuelo sin fin. Presentes.
it's important to pass on the information about your ancestors, about the people in your family that you want to keep in their memory alive and pass it down to the new generations, to the children, to the young people. And that's what keeps this connection. It's a line of memory of not only remembrance and also this continuing of our own lineage, of our own heritage, our own roots. And you know, it has been said and it is known that, you know, as long as one person remembers, that person is not going to, will never die.
Damas y caballeros, nosotros somos Tropa Magica de East Los Angeles, California, para el mundo. Esta primera canción se llama Starry Eyed Lover. La luz de tus fotos que han captado.
lado nuestra afección. Suspendidas en el tiempo, se despiertan en movimiento y te sientas en mis piernas otra vez. Y te abrazo, nos besamos otra vez. Cada momento más sagrado que el siguiente, en las fotos de ayer. Borracharme en tu amor, despertar bien crudo en tu corazón, con tu afección y te sientas en mis piernas otra vez. Y te abrazo, nos besamos otra vez. Fotos de ayer. If you're watching this, sing along with us. Don't be shy. It's okay.
Forget to go to selfhelpgraphics.com, Dia de los Muertos, after the show to learn more about Noche de Ofrenda and all of Self Help's Dia de los Muertos seasonal workshops and events.
Yes, Self Help Graphics and Art is known for its groundbreaking community arts programs, from the Barrio Mobile Art Studio to their affordable and free workshops, but in particular for its world-class professional printmaking program.
Yeah, self-help is home to many working artists from this very community and an iconic cultural arts institution championing the art and culture for people like you, like me, like us. Let's hear now from Marbella Muro, self-help graphics director of artistic programs and education.
Hello, my name is Marbella Muro. I'm the Director of Artistic Programs and Education. At Self Help Graphics, the Day of the Dead is more than a day or two. It's a whole season, and we're trying to maintain that tradition this year. First, each week during the month of October, a pre-recorded video of an art workshop is launched. The workshops have Spanish subtitles and are accessible on YouTube. The workshops include papel picado, paper flowers, shoebox altar, and a face painting tutorial that will stream live on Instagram. Secondly, thinking about our immediate neighbors who may or may not have internet access, we created art bundles to distribute. The art bundles included bilingual educational zines or activity books with instructions and historical information about each craft's significance. The zine is available for download on our website. Aware of the virtual realm that is our permanent reality, we created something entirely new for us. Combining tradition with new technologies, we worked with Maestra Ofelia Esparza and Rosanna Esparza of Tonali Studio and the VR tech company Tecno Latinx to transform an altar into an AR experience. Beautiful triggers were created using Esparza's designs, such as a hummingbird, a monarch butterfly, papel picado, and more. And these were brought to life and experienced as Instagram filters. Throughout the season, we will be highlighting individual artworks by the 17 artists in the exhibition Ofrendas 2020 via blogs, audio, and video recordings, and on our virtual program, Artist Lab, that will air on November 2nd at 7 p.m. You can find all the details on selfhopgraphics.com/Dia de los Muertos.
Hi, I'm State Senator Marilena Durazo, representing the communities of Los Angeles and East LA. Thank you, Betty, and thank you, Self-Help Graphics, for providing much needed uplifting during these very challenging times. Congratulations, felicidades, on your 47th annual Día de los Muertos celebration. You are so important to our community. You help us continue to celebrate the essence of our culture, to keep us grounded and connected during this COVID-19. I know now more than ever, our familia and our loved ones that have passed are with us, helping us push through. Let's show our respect and build those altares with pictures and marigold flowers and sugar skulls and food and candles and beer. Our loved ones will be with us forever. En honor de nuestros queridos, feliz Día de los Muertos.
All right, our next performer hails from Tijuana, Baja California. She was one of the first women to rise in the ranks of contemporary Latinx alternative rock, touring alongside acclaimed singer Julieta Venegas. In 2006, she embarked on her solo career and hasn't looked back. Let's give a warm welcome to Ceci Bastida.
No sé qué hora será mejor, si esperar la puesta del sol. Puedo mi cuerpo cambiar. Aprendí a deslizar. Soy como un ninja, nadie me ve. Ni una huella dejaré. Vengo entrenando de tiempo atrás. Estoy lista. Dale que dale que dale que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale que dale que dale que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale que dale que dale que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale que dale que dale que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Mucha gente me quiere. No me dejarán en paz. Creen que es peligro tenerme aquí. Que no los dejaré vivir. Que el mundo no debería cambiar. Cada quien en su lugar. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da. No daré ni un paso atrás. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da. No daré ni un paso atrás. Solo puedo pensar en mí, no esperar nada de ti. Nunca nadie quiso ver por mí, con el tiempo lo entendí. Yo solo puedo pensar en mí, no esperar nada de ti. Dale, que dale, que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da, dale, que dale, que dale, que da, no daré ni un paso atrás. Dale, que dale, que dale, que da, dale, que dale, que dale, que da, no daré ni un paso atrás.
Gracias a todos por estar aquí. Viendo desde sus casas, mi nombre es Ceci Bastida
y estamos aquí celebrando el Día de Muertos. Así que bueno, recordemos a la gente que queremos, no nos olvidemos de la gente que ya se fue. Les mando mucho cariño y feliz de poder tocar de nuevo.
I know all this talk about Dia de los Muertos and self-help graphics has us muy excited. But I'm here to remind you that our election is Tuesday, November 3rd. I know y'all know because we've been screaming it from the top of our lungs since we got into it. And I'm here to encourage all of you to vote, vote, vote. There is so much at stake in this election, and your vote is your voice. If you live in California, you should already have a ballot at home, so get it done and vote like your life depends on it, because it literally does. If you don't vote, I'm gonna send all my little ancestors to come and pull your toes in the middle of the night. Just kidding. Let's go vote. And now, a message from our local assembly member, Miguel Santiago, and assembly member, Wendy Carrillo.
Buenas, soy Miguel Santiago, y aquí estamos celebrando el Día de los Muertos, aquí con Self Help Graphics. We're here to celebrate all the rich culture, our diversity, and all the people around. So a big hug from my family, yours, and let's keep celebrating.
Hi, I'm Assemblywoman Wendy Carrillo, proudly representing the 51st Assembly District, home to the original self-help graphics right here in East Los Angeles, where I, as a young girl, used to take art classes. Art played an important role for me then and plays an important role for me now. And as we commemorate the 47th annual Día de los Muertos self-help graphics celebration, I can't help but wonder about the 200,000 people that have passed away because of COVID. We need art more than ever before to remind us what life is worth living for. So amid COVID, stay safe, stay healthy, wear your mask, and love one another.
Annie.
What?
Do you love art as much as I do?
I do.
Well, then support self-help graphics by buying a print. Oh. It's easy. Shop directly at self-help's Facebook or their Instagram. And you can also go to www.selfhelpgraphics.com/shop. Select the print you want, the quantity, and then just go to checkout. And then soon thereafter, somebody from self-help will call you to arrange for pickup or shipping.
You know, I do think that I heard something about that. You want to know what else I heard?
What?
Girl, I heard that every print purchased is reinvested into programs right here at Self Help Graphics. I know, so smart. So go ahead and shop for a cause and support the artists who make Self Help Graphics a place we all call home. And now, for a limited time, go to the website and check out our Muertos Market vendors. Get special discounts on select vendor stores and while supporting local businesses. You're welcome.
Metro commissioned artist Sonia Romero has created Hecho a Mano, a new mural that will soon be installed at Mariachi Plaza Station. Let's take a sneak peek at the creation process and the new artwork coming to our Boyle Heights neighborhood.
Hola, Betty. This is Kevin de León. I want to welcome each and every one of you to the 47th annual virtual ceremony of Self-Help Graphics. Now, I want to say that Self-Help Graphics is so incredibly important to all of us in the city of Los Angeles, but in particular, Boyle Heights, because it is one of the cultural headquarters we have of our own expression of cultura, arte, to not just the residents of Boyle Heights, but to the rest of the city, the state, the nation, as well as the world. For the first time, you can have Chicano, Mexican American, Latin American voices that are heard, that are seen, more important, visually. And that's why Self-Help Graphics is so critical to Boyle Heights and to LA. So to all the incredible supporters, to the incredible staff, to you, Betty, gracias for everything that you do for each and every one of us. Now, I wish that we could be together, without a doubt, and celebrate this incredible nonprofit organization on First Street. But we will get together sooner rather than later. Let's make sure that we support Self-Help Graphics, and let's make sure that our culture is being told and it is seen by all. Gracias a todos.
Day of the Dead is a sacred time for Self-Help Graphics. It's a time of bringing community together and healing together. And we're so proud to be bringing you one of the longest running celebrations in the country and certainly the longest in Los Angeles. Since the early 1970s, this is a celebration that's been very closely connected to the Chicano identity and that has been a platform for social justice for artists and community members to speak to the issues that are relevant to them at the time. We've seen anywhere from ASCO in the early 1970s addressing the ways that they were seeing their peers dying in the East Side, to the femicidio in Mexico, to most recently Black Lives Matter and the immigration issue and children being caged up in borders. I think with the quarantine and the way that the virus has impacted our community so much, and now this incredible racial justice movement, Day of the Dead, seems like it's so very needed in such an urgent way. And it makes us all the more sad that we can't bring this to you in person this year due to the virus. We can't risk our community members' health, especially given how badly the Latino community has been impacted. Thank you for being part of the 47th annual Día de los Muertos at Self Help Graphics and Art in this virtual iteration. And we hope to see you next year in person.
Yay! We would like to thank all of you, all who have made today possible.
Yes, and Tia, you know what? I'd like to thank you.
I want to thank you, honey.
Okay, thanks. If you would like to donate to Self Help Graphics, you can do so by visiting selfhelpgraphics.com/donate. Or you can text to give. Honestly, it is super easy and it doesn't have to be a lot, all right? Just give what you can. Take out your phone and text DOD 202-41444 to make a one-time or recurring donation. Let me give you that text number again. You're going to text DOD 20 and you're going to text that to 41444 just to make a one-time or a recurring donation if your pockets are full. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
We hope everyone stays safe, honoring their ancestors this year, and you enjoy our performance.
Thank you.